What's January going to be like, Simon, for Tottenham Hotspur, do you think? Is it going to be a make or break month regarding Antonio Conte being a success at Tottenham? Because it could be in some way something of a litmus test in terms of the relationship between Conte, the relationship with him and Levy, yeah. The relationship with him and the board. Now, with the transfer window opening, Conte yesterday was put in the spot and he was asked straight if he's now had the right amount of time to evaluate his present squad.
Yeah, I think so. No, I think, but I'm sure 100%. And I made the evaluation after 2 months, after 2 months of work with my players, and for sure now the situation is more clear than before. I'm waiting to have a meeting with the club and then also to give my opinion about the squad and. What I think about our situation, and for sure I'm waiting for a meeting.
Uh-huh. Okay, that's pretty clear, isn't it?
Well, he's waiting for a meeting.
Yeah,
so he hasn't had the meeting yet. Does that surprise you?
No, I'm sure he's in communication with Daniel Levy. I mean, we've seen the videos of Daniel Levy in the All or Nothing series hanging around the training ground, so I'm sure that he will have had conversations with Daniel, and I'm sure explicitly and implicitly there would have been conversations about what his expectations are, because don't forget it's Tottenham that have chased him, not the other way round. He didn't ask for an interview, he turned them down. They went back and revisited it and were desperate to get him after a point, after you know, removing Espirito Santo. Here we are with a manager that we know he's got history on wanting what he wants when he wants it.
Right.
And of course, if you don't mind that to some extent, as long as they deliver. What you don't like is when managers want what they want, get what they want, and don't deliver with it. This guy does deliver. So with that in mind, Daniel Levy would be under no illusion. This wasn't a job that he needed to have Antonio Conte. There would have been an embarrassment of riches of jobs that he could have taken.
True,
right? So he's taken Tottenham because he'll have been given assurances. Now, what we've heard from him recently is goalkeepers. That's all we've heard. We've heard him index himself to Jordan Pickford, and we've heard him index himself to Sam Johnson as a goalkeeper. So that's the only thing we've heard. But now he's made it clear. I've identified, he would have known what the squad consisted of. These football people will have evaluated what squad he was inheriting, and what he's got in the door and found out is character, culture of the players, and who's a lightweight and who's not, right? So he'll be in there now looking at that sort of thing and thinking, right, okay, this is what I want to add. Now, of course, Daniel's going to want to not do bad business in January, because most of the business you do in January, with a few exceptions, of course, Suarez being one of them, a few others that we can probably pull out and say were good businesses in January.
Beverton,
but on the whole, they're remedial business, but they're also bad business, because agents will sit there and maximise the opportunity of people's needs.
Yeah.
They're seventh in the league. They're 2 games away from... they've got 2 games in hand. If they win those 2 games, they go fourth. It doesn't help the landscape that Arsenal are in good nick, and Arsenal are in fourth space. So they're across North London, they're looking at their biggest rivals recovering some poise.
For sure.
Now, I can't imagine if Conte wants players and knows who those players are, that he's going to find himself talking to a wall. Because if he does, then Levy will have taken somebody on, I suspect, under false pretenses. Because whilst we don't know the details, I think most sensible people will understand this guy leaves into Milan because he's being told his players are being sold and he's being told that he can't have further investment. He's hardly going to rock up to Tottenham Hotspur. He's already sued Chelsea, got paid a load of money. So
true.
He's not short of a bob or two.
Yeah.
So he's come into Tottenham and he will have been given, I would imagine, a certain level of assurance. And if he wants to play those cards in January to build up the momentum,
now's the time to do it.
He'll do it. He'll do it either which way. Now, he's made his position clear. He didn't pull away from the fact that he liked the squad, and he didn't do the Mourinho thing of my biggest Christmas gift was the squad I've got. He's told you he wants to sign players. Now, it'd be fascinating to see who those players are and what they look like and whether there has to be some trading, because what Levy will try and do, if he's going to give him what he wants, which I suspect he will be, Daniel will then be saying, but I'd like to get rid of some people. I'd like the boys that Jose signed that you don't want.
But Conte will want to get rid of some as well.
And he should want to.
Yeah.
And if that's facilitatory to Daniel Levy giving him additional money, then fantastic. I'd like to think Tottenham are going to be ambitious because they've got an ambitious manager. They've made a statement. Conte is a live one. He's a real one. He's a current one.
Mm. Right? And Levy said they're ambitious.
And so here you are. So now it's about what kind of business that looks like. And it'd be interesting to see where Conte goes, because we don't quite know what he thinks of the unit he's got. We don't know quite where he thinks he needs improvements. Yeah. So we're going to see all that play out, and then we're going to see what Tottenham is going to become under Conte.
Does that not intrigue you about Tottenham, though? About what they might do?
Of course it does.
Because the first time Conte goes into the market, it could be a wow moment.
Because you'll always have that element of it's Spursy. You know, it'll always be that sort of thing about Tottenham that they're not just quite there. Right, but they've got a guy now that doesn't fit the mould of not quite there. They've got a guy that fits the mould of wanting to be there, demanding to be there, and actually having been there.
Yeah,
right?
Yeah.
So here we are with a Premier League winner, a Serie A winner, with Tottenham Hotspur, with a juxtaposed chairman that doesn't like spending that much money.
Yeah.
But I think it'll be interesting.
What if Conte doesn't get what he wants in the month of January?
Well, you know how that looks.
The landscape will change.
Well, you know how that looks for Conte. He's made no... in the past bones about what he does and doesn't want and how he doesn't want to manage. So with that in mind, I find it incomprehensible that he's not going to get support, because if that's the case, that he doesn't get support, then you're going to find a division and you're going to find fissures very quickly. But I think he's taken the job basically knowing he's going to get what he wants.
Yeah.
Jim White and Simon Jordan, Monday to Thursday morning, 10 till 1. On AM, on DAB, via the talkSPORT app, and on your smart speaker. talkSPORT.